Good morning and welcome to my Pig and Pathworks. Today's video is another garden update. And so here in Texas, we've had some really freakish weather. So I'm holding off on planting outside unless it's frost hardy, probably till after Easter. But I wanted to go ahead and get some things that I could started. Now in here, I kind of figured out a little late and my seedlings were getting kind of leggy. As you can see, they're kind of leggy. The ones in the middle are good because the light's been shining on them. But I do have a fan going on them now. That's been helping with the legginess. And so not everything is coming up, and that's okay. I just finished my planning this morning. Everything that I'm gonna start indoors is basically started already. And I'm looking forward to giving these babies some time outdoors. As soon as the weather warms up enough. So that's where we are starting my seedlings. Alrighty, so this is the progress that I have made so far on the garden. So my brother and his wife got me some grow bags for Christmas, and these are specifically for potatoes. So I got a potato already growing in that. I just planted that yesterday. I have enough dirt for one more because they got me two bags. And then I've decided that I'm going to go ahead and fill up those buckets and use them for potatoes too. I'm kind of waiting to see if this lemongrass is going to come back up in the spring. My rosemary pretty much survived the snowmageddon. It needed all this water, because while it was in the greenhouse, I forgot to water them. And so now I've lost all my mint. So I'm waiting to see if it's going to come back or if I'm going to have to start all over again. If I have to start all over again, that's fine. I have a little box I'm going to put the mint in instead of this plastic cauldron. I still haven't been able to get the dirt for this. And I have discovered that to do the whole garden the way I really wanted it to be, it's going to be close to $500 or $600. So I'm going to have to do it in steps. However, this is finished completely. And I have already planted in here some onions and some peas. So the peas are I found this metal in the ground when I was cleaning up that spot. This is the cleanest piece of metal I've got to use, and I have to use what I have on hand, so hopefully this will work for those peas to climb up. We'll see how well that works. For this year, I will probably replace it with a cattle panel next year. But right now, this is going to have to do. And I have started my planting in the box. I've got some lettuce growing. Even if it does frost, the hybrid lettuce that I planted here is frost hardy. And so is this red kale from Baker Seeds. So I went ahead and planted those this morning. And so hopefully, cross our fingers, we're going to be good to go on that. The strawberries are looking good. They survived Snowmageddon very well. I haven't done anything with this part of the garden before. This section of the garden was where I was wanting to plant my radishes, but it looks like I'm just gonna have to do a no dig on this. Well, I'm gonna dig up all this grass, because it looks like the soil really needs to be amended over here. It's got too much clay. So I'm gonna have to get another bag of dirt, just to put that, plant those radishes there and do some soil amendments to get the soil prepared. Over here, on this side of the garden is where I was gonna put the carrots, in a small bed in the ground, as well as over here being, where I was gonna put the squash, because those grow bags that I had over here last year just kind of disintegrated. So it really, it has already started the amendment process for this bed, so I feel comfortable maybe getting a couple more bags of dirt, garden soil, to put over here. I think it should be fine. So that's about it for the garden. We don't have anything growing on the porch or in the greenhouse right now. So it is coming along. We still have to put up, as you see over here, over this part, you can see the top part of the fence. We need to put that all the way around. We haven't managed to be able to do that. And all the way around the top of the garden. And so that's going to be a project for my next day off, is getting that all the way up and around. And so the rest of it is, I'm just going to have to do it a little at a time. Anyway, I just wanted to give you guys an update to show you the progress we've made on the garden.